Heads up, I have not seen this list yet. I'm going to be reacting to this with you, so I'm nervous. Oh my god, I feel like I'm gonna expose all my bad music listening habits today. It's fine. Hello, my beans. How are you guys doing? I hope you are well. I am nervous. Oh my god. I just feel like y'all are gonna hurt me. So today, you guys, I'm going to be exposing my 50 most listened to tracks in the year of 2020. I use a website called Last.fm. I don't know if you guys use this website at all, but you can see literally like exactly every track you've listened to the entire year, the number of times you've listened to it. Like, it's actually pretty cool. So I had my brother make this playlist for me, like go on that website, make a playlist of my top 50. So I haven't seen this yet. I have no idea. Let's go ahead. I'm gonna open the playlist. I'm gonna try and not look at the songs. I already know who the first artist is. The cover image that my brother gave this playlist is a picture of Kingsley Coman and Alfonso Davies, and it makes my heart really happy, and I appreciate him for that. I just want to take a quick second to plug my Patreon, you guys. If you haven't checked out the Patreon yet, basically over there you can get shoutouts, requests, Uncut album reactions, Run BTS, exclusive reactions, reactions that are blocked on YouTube. There's a bunch of things over there if you guys want to check it out. It's also just a great way to help support the channel and me if you want to. I would not be able to continue to do what I do here without my patrons. So thank you so much to everybody who has already gone over to my Patreon. You guys have changed everything for me and I appreciate you so much. And again, if you want to check it out, I will link it down below. Without any further ado, oh my god, let's listen to my top 50 tracks. 2020. I already know who the first artist is, but I don't know what the first song is. Number 50, you guys. What is it? Is this on? This is one of the very first BTS songs I really got to know because this music video came out in March, I want to say. And this was like right when I got into BTS, so it's so funny this is here. Oh my god, I don't even know which one this is. Wait, I gotta figure this out. Oh, which one is this? I don't know the titles of his songs, of Justin Vernon's songs. I don't know. I listen to this when I read though. What is it? Oh, Lump Sum! I did not expect to see Boney Bear on this list. Oh my god, this makes sense though. Whenever I hear songs from this album or his other album, the one that's up there, I think of The Shining by Stephen King because these are the two albums I would listen to while reading that book. They fit so perfectly. Like, I don't know what it is. Oh my god, it's just the whole imagery just enters my mind. It's amazing. I can't believe this isn't higher. Oh no, I love this song so much. Let's go!
We're now going to progress to some steps which are a bit more difficult.
This makes me think that all my BTS songs are at the end of this because this would definitely be one of my most listened to, without a doubt. Oh, Dynamite though. We're still gonna run into Dynamite and Boy With Love probably. I'm pretty sure this is my favorite BTS song. Ego is so much fun and just so much joy. I didn't mean to do that. Yeah, I know the words. What? I'm being exposed. No way is this in my top 50. It literally came out like yesterday. This video goes out to all the people who said I only listen to BTS for the channel and then I do it for the views. I mean, have you seen this list so far? A girl has a problem, and that girl is me. I gotta go. This is not good. This is such a problem. This is embarrassing. This is embarrassing. This is officially embarrassing. Put your ass on me. Don't mind me. That's what I hear every time. I'm sorry. DNA, DNA. Oh, good. Whew. I was like, what is this song? How do you say her name? I always say MXM tune, but I feel like that's wrong. I'll be right back. Me spilling coffee on myself while I film is just like a tradition now. I want something more than we go now. Really? What? No way. I did not think this would be on here. No way. If this is on here, Daisy's is definitely on here. There's no way. That smile, smile.
Am I allowed to look at her like that?
No, this song is so beautiful.
And she's just so nice to look at.
No way.
She tastes like apple juice and peach.
Not all my emotional little bops together. Goodbye.
No one has loved me like I love them.
Okay, it's fine. What's next?
See that you're over. Real sweet, but I wish you were sober.
Let's go, Boldy Bear. Okay, Bon Iver's music depresses me though, so I just don't want to spend much time here. Alright, that's enough. Nope. Yeah, it is enough. You're right. Wait, which song is this? Oh, I feel like I haven't listened to this in ages.
None could compare to the shine in your eyes.
What song is this? Oh, Make You Happy? Wow, this is actually really depressing.
All of my dreams. You deserve someone who loves you with all that they have. Even if the one who loves you is some other man.
Anything I listened to this song early in the year. And now it hurts me. This is actually gonna get real depressing real fast. Yes! Oh my god.
I'm a superhero. I lost her. I want her back. They say
I'm so
broke up in a safe house singing, honey, let's get married. Don't wanna walk alone.
I love bleachers.
So let's get married at all.
This entire album is gonna be here. It's a ball.
To Paris, you lie like the city of lies, and you fight like my parents about who and what and when. I do my head toss, check my nails, baby, how you feeling? If he don't love you anymore, just walk your fine ass out the door. I do my head toss. I'm afraid of flying, cause I'm afraid of dying. Getting to tell you goodbye.
This song is depressing as hell.
Waking up to someone breaking in and taking every little thing that I love. I'll always be afraid of losing you. I will.
What song is this? Oh, we made it to Folklore already? Oh boy. Wait, if this is in my top 50, oh my god, the entirety of Folklore is gonna be in here from here on out. Oh no.
Crawling up the beaches now.
This song shouldn't be illegal. It's so fucking sad.
Crush always making me feel like I got nothing to offer.
This song wasn't one of my favorites when I first listened to Conan, and then it became my favorite over time. It's like my number one favorite Conan song. But it didn't start off that way, so I'm not surprised it's not near like the top.
So why are you trying to leave when you know that I'm the king?
This song is so good. my favorite dance songs. Oh, manic, manic, manic.
I'm gonna jot it down and then get it out, and then I'll be on my way. Oh, you're not half the man you think that you are. Glad I never ever had a baby with you.
Forty-seven times I listened to this song. And that's only on Spotify. I listen to this in the car with my CD all the time too, so... whoops. We are officially at the halfway point, and we've only hit two folklore songs, which, you know, is a little bit of a problem. But let's go to number 25. It's probably gonna be a folklore song.
Please,
yeah. This is me trying has grown on me a lot more than 7S. Gotta say.
Aren't there still beautiful things?
You know, I don't know, Taylor. I don't know.
Till it actually happens.
Yup. Yup. I love Katy Perry. I love her so much as a person. I just, love her. I have so much love for Katy Perry. She's so real. Like, when you really, like, watch her interviews and stuff and songs like this, like, she's so real. And I just love that about her. This song hurts every ounce of my entire body. Let's go. Let's go. This song is, oh, just this year, this song is perfect. Why do I want to cry just hearing those notes? Like, why?
Green was the color of the grass where I used to read at Centennial Park.
My hope song right here. This is my hope song.
Tying you to me.
I listen to Mirabal more than Invisible String? No way. Wow. Oh, because of the bridge. It's because of the damn bridge, which breaks my soul.
I'm still on that tightrope. I'm still trying everything to get you laughing at me.
Nash! I love Nash.
I went out last night so sure that I would never miss you this bad. Cause now I'm all over.
I'm not gonna pretend to be surprised every time we get a folklore song because, yeah, we know.
Make sure nobody sees you leave.
This song is definitely one of my favorites on the album now. I don't know that it was my favorite back in July when we first heard this album, but now this song, it's the bridge on this one too.
This idiotic fool that you made me. You taught me a secret language I can't speak.
Oh, duh. Okay. I'm like getting all the folklore beginnings mixed up because all I've been listening to right now is Evermore. Bye! Oh, wait, this one's pretty high up because it ended up being one of my favorites like recently, and I listened to it a lot recently. That explains it. How many times? 53 times I've listened to this song this year. 53.
Does she smile? Does she mouth fuck you forever?
Crush culture! Yes, this is, yep.
Crush culture makes me wanna spill my guts out. I know what you're doing, trying to get me to pursue ya.
Oh!
I'm slowly killing myself.
I wish this song wasn't so high up.
Trying so hard at the back. Can someone help me?
I'm fine, guys.
Can someone help me?
Exposed. Just no. Why Why are there so many depressing songs at the top? Oh, exposed, exposed.
There's a knife in my chest, but I'm trying my best.
This is the most painful video I've ever made. Is it possible to feel your heart physically melting? Because, this is so fucking depressing. Can we...
If I'm on fire...
No. Betty! Wait, how many times? 56 times I listened to Betty. One thing I will say about Betty is that it was my favorite, but I listened to it so many times, like on repeat, and I was learning it on the piano, and I did learn it on the piano. So like it's not my favorite anymore because I listened to it way too much. So this is actually gonna take us to the top 10. These are the top 10 songs I listened to this year. Top 10. Okay. This is not fun. When I first heard Exile, I did love this song, but it wasn't until like a week or two later that it actually became super relatable. Like, so when my first reaction to this, I was like, yeah, great, woohoo. A couple weeks later, I was like, oh my god, the first verse is so on point that it doesn't feel good. Really? Call me. How many times I listened to this? 59. You maniac. There's actually one song that has not been in my top 50 yet that I'm shocked hasn't been here. So if it's not in the top 8, I will be mind blown. This is my favorite Conan Gray song. This song is just super vibey. Like, I get super strong slow-mo visuals in my head every time I listen to this song. Oh, I can't believe, what is this? Number 8. I listened to this 60 times this year, yeah. Okay, where are we going? Number 7. Yes, here it is! I found it. Yes!
Be lonely with you.
This is the song I was talking about.
Maybe love is over.
Honestly, like, if I had to say, like, what was my favorite song of 2020, it would be this. I don't think this song came out in 2020. This came out in 2018, but it's my favorite song of 2020. I could listen to this song 100 times. I do not get tired of it. Whoa, I thought we were done with BTS. Whoa, how many times? 60.
How's your day? Oh, tell me. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Come be my teacher.
Okay, Jen. We are going into our top 5. I think I know what number 1 is because it was spoiled for me by Spotify Wrapped. And I already know Folklore still has to be in the top 5. All right, let's find out. Number 5. What is it? I forgot. Not me forgetting about BTS again.
Let's rock and roll.
How many times did I listen to this song? 62 times? Didn't this come out in like August? Oh, you know what? See, Folklore, okay, here's the thing with the Folklore songs being where they are. Folklore, for some reason, was an album that I always had to listen to in order. Like, Evermore I'll put on shuffle. Folklore, I always listen to in order. So that will explain this. How many times did I listen to Cardigan? 70? Yikes. Yup.
Rebecca rode up on the afternoon train. It was sunny.
See, this is another situation too where this was one of my favorites when the album first came out, and since then it's dropped a lot because, again, I listen to the album in order all the time, so I would listen to this song way too often. And also, when I wanted to be happy and still listen to Folklore, this is the song that I would listen to because every other song hurt me, except for this one. This was the only song on the album that I could listen to and like feel happy. All right, I know what number two is gonna be. I know what number two is gonna be. This was supposed to be number one, which means two songs switched at the last minute. This was number one on my Spotify Wrapped.
Your eyes so crystal clean, style of apple baby, but you taste so sweet. She got hips like Jagger and two left feet.
I love this song so much. Lyrically, the music, I mean, Halsey, period. Halsey, girl. It's just so pretty. This takes us to my number one most listened to song of 2020, and I think you probably know what it is. I think we all know what it is. It's my favorite song off of this album. It wrecks my soul, but I love it. And here it is. Here it is. Yeah. Yeah, this is pretty safe to say. How many times did I listen to it? 80? Don't look at me.
I thought I saw you at the bus stop, I didn't though.
This line.
You know the greatest films of all time were never made.
Bye. This song is probably like top three Taylor songs for me ever. It's definitely my favorite between Folklore and Evermore. Alright, you guys, so those are my 50 most listened to songs of 2020. Almost all of Folklore made it, but unsurprisingly, the ones that didn't make it were Peace and Hoax, and those are the last two on the album. So that kind of goes along with the whole listening to it in order thing. But the one 100% deserves to be where it is. That is my favorite song off of the album. Halsey, BTS was so much higher than I expected them to be. Conan Gray was up there. There's a lot of surprises in here, and then a lot of like, of course this song is on here moments. I was waiting for Sports by Beach Bunny to show up because I love that song so freaking much. So my top 10 was literally made up of Taylor Swift, Conan Gray, Beach Bunny, BTS, and Halsey. Halsey was there twice, Taylor Swift was there multiple times, BTS multiple times, Conan Gray multiple times, and then like Beach Bunny was just kind of chilling there. But feel free to let me know, you guys, what your top songs of 2020 were. I know you guys probably got your information from Spotify Wrapped. I just don't trust Spotify Wrapped because they stopped collecting data in like October, and you can't see the exact number of plays for all your songs, whereas with Last.fm you can. I totally recommend for 2021, sign up for Last.fm because it's really cool to look at all your stats and everything. This is not like sponsored or anything. I just love that website. I think it's so cool. But those are my top songs of 2020, you guys. Thank you so much for watching this, hanging out with me. Thank you for an amazing freaking year. This has been the craziest year for so many reasons, but for me specifically, for me personally, like the whole YouTube situation has been absolutely crazy this year. Thank you so much for getting me to 100K. That means so freaking much to me. Like, I can't even, my brain can't comprehend 100,000 people. That's too many. That's way too many people. But I'm so grateful for all of you. So thank you so much. And 2021, let's make it better. We'll make it better. It'll be better. But thank you guys so much for being here. Thank you, my beans. Don't forget to like, subscribe if you want to. And I will see you guys in my next video in 2021. Bye, guys.